If a body is found in a field and the cops suspect foul play is involved, establishing the exact time of death is critical. Figuring out the deceased's final moments can help investigators corroborate people's stories to ultimately hone in on a killer. But how do you do that? There are a few traditional ways to tell when someone died. Forensic examiners can measure body temperature, skin color, and degree of rigor mortis. Each of these changes as the body begins decomposing, so knowing the stage of change, they can work backwards to figure out the time of death. But all those methods only really work in the first 72 hours. Any longer and those factors have peaked, meaning the changes have happened and there's no more data to glean. So when a body has been a corpse for more than 3 days, investigators have to use other methods to determine the time of death. One way is to look at all the different insects that feed on dead human flesh. Insects are drawn to the gases and fluids released by a decomposing body. To them, it's fertile ground to lay their eggs and cultivate their young. The first insect to reach a corpse is usually a blowfly, which will lay eggs within 2 days of a person's death. Flesh flies also move in early in the decaying process. Decomposing body fat attracts hide beetles and pyralid moths. As time goes by and flesh breaks down, other species of flies and beetles that have mouths to chew tougher food move in, consuming the dead flesh. From there, the corpse becomes an ecosystem with insects feeding on the corpse and also feeding on each other. This is all super gross, but super important. Entomologists know the life cycle of all these insects, specifically the all-important blowfly that lays its eggs in the dead body first. When determining time of death, they can look at the stage of development of the blowfly, whether it's an egg, larva, pupa, or adult, and take into account environmental factors like heat and insect patterns to work backwards and figure out approximately when the blowfly laid its eggs, which can tell them the time of death. We're really good at this, but there's a problem. We need to know exactly what species that larva is, because they all sort of look alike. The examiner needs to know the species for a better estimation of development time and time of death. They can do a DNA test on an egg, but that can be pricey. The cheaper option is to collect the egg and let it grow to adulthood in a lab to figure out the species and work backwards from there. Of course, if you're trying to find out who killed someone and left them in a field, waiting 3 or so days for a fly egg to become a fully formed insect is stressful. A criminal can flee to a new country by then. Knowing the egg identification thing is an issue, an organic chemist teamed up with a forensic entomologist to apply real-time mass spectrometry to blowfly eggs, and it could be a game-changer for forensic science. Before we get to that, though, they had to learn all about these species of flies. To do that, the researchers put pork liver in traps hidden around Manhattan. Yes, this is real science. They attracted 4 species of blowfly and trapped them before they were able to lay eggs. They then determined their species and put them on a fresh liver to seed their spawn. That way, the researchers knew what species were laying eggs where. The researchers then collected the eggs and tested each in a mass spectrometer to get a chemical fingerprint. Mass spectrometry is really complicated to explain, but basically, a sample is ionized, the atoms are sorted by mass and charge, and it gives you a graph that looks something like this. With this, we can figure out what atoms something is made of, what they call the chemical fingerprint. And since everything is made of atoms, we can apply this technology to things like uncovering the amino acids in a blowfly egg. Knowing the species, then analyzing the eggs, gave them the first ever chemically based way to identify blowfly eggs, and it only takes minutes to do. Ideally, if this tech works, entomologists can use all the data from the crime scene and a quick mass spectrometry check of the fly larvae to find an approximate time of death. But we can't use this to catch criminals just yet. Scientists will need to measure the chemical signature of more species and then create a database against which spectra of unknown eggs can be compared. This promises to advance forensic entomology and, by extension, help investigators act quickly when faced with a dead body in a field. But let's say no one found the body in the field until it was picked clean by insects. Then forensic examiners have to figure out what happened using just a skull. I talk about that in this episode right here. So did you make it through this video without vomiting? I almost didn't. Let us know your thoughts in the comments, subscribe, and come back here for more Seeker.